Shukran. Thank you, Nihad. Assalamu alaikum. Hello and welcome to New York's Times Square for Cinema Weekly. We have a lot to show you this week, but first let's see what happened last week at the American box office.
Everybody look at Hollywood, doing it, doing it, doing it good. Everybody look at Hollywood, doing it, doing it, doing it good.
Moviegoers flocked to The Equalizer, starring Denzel Washington, which had a stunning $34 million debut. Good for a top five all-time finish for a September opening. Next up was The Maze Runner and new release The Box Trolls, which were in a virtual dead heat at about $17 million each. The star-studded This Is Where I Leave You fell sharply to $6 million, and family film Dolphin Tale 2 rounded out the top five. Here's what some moviegoers thought of these flicks.
Gone Girl.
I want to see Bang Bang and Heather.
I just gonna see Gone Girl.
She wants to see Gone Girl. Nothing against Ben Affleck. I think he's a wonderful actor. But we want to see Annabelle.
I'm going to watch Left Behind.
Because it's horror. I love it.
She likes scary movies.
Yes.
David Fincher can do no wrong, but the ending is still rage-inducing.
I'm here about a girl.
For what?
Her freedom.
Take out five pimps. You took out the East Coast hub of the Russian mafia.
One day someone does something unspeakable, someone you hardly knew. So you do something about it, because no one else is going to.
He won't stop until he kills you and anyone you care about.
A man with his skills.
Possibly military training.
I kind of wanted to throw my popcorn at the end, but I mean, visually, the film was amazing. It was, you know, good screenplay and great acting, but... You know, if you read the book, you won't be surprised.
It's amazing. It's really amazing. It's a wonderful film.
Great.
It's well written. I'm so with the film right now, I can't even...
One film we didn't mention as it opens this weekend is Gone Girl, based on a novel by Gillian Flynn. The question we are asked in this film is, did Nick Dunn kill his wife? Is he done for the count? Okay, that was bad. But his late wife's family sure thinks so. It is a seemingly ripped from the headline suspense thriller with veteran actor Ben Affleck plus Neil Patrick Harris, Tyler Perry, and more. This one is not for the kids. Here's a look.
As you all know, my wife, Amy Elliott Dunn, disappeared 3 days ago. I had nothing to do with the disappearance of my wife. I have nothing to hide.
Sammy, got friends we can talk to?
No, not really.
You don't know if she has friends, you don't know what she does all day, and you don't know your wife's blood type.
Just being a good guy, so everybody can see him being a good guy.
Well, you really don't like him, do you?
All I'm trying to do is be nice. You ever see that guy in the glasses before?
Amy is the kind of girl who attracts admirers.
Whoever took her is bound to bring her back.
I'm hoping you can tell me what this means.
You want to solve Amy's treasure, huh?
You seen this girl around here?
Yeah, I remember her.
I know you. I saw you at the volunteer center.
In The Maze Runner, a group of boys find themselves thrown into the middle of nowhere, one by one. And along comes Thomas, played by Dylan O'Brien of Teen Wolf fame, and Game of Thrones weirdo dream boy Thomas Brody Sangster, who plays Newt in this mystery where amnesiac Thomas needs to find his way out of a maze, or it's lights out for good.
What is this place?
Can you tell me your name?
I can't remember anything.
Who put us here? We don't know.
What's out there?
The maze.
Every morning when those doors open,
the runners look for a way out. And no one has ever survived a night in the maze.
What happens to them?
We don't belong here.
I think it's time we find out what we're really up against.
Everything started changing the moment you showed up.
It's a girl.
Thomas,
Why are we different?
What if we were sent here for a reason?
It's part of the New York Film Festival.
It's odd. Some people might not like it, but it's a great film.
I think Gone Girl is more mystery.
Yeah.
In another family flick we mentioned earlier called The Box Trolls, a little boy is raised not by wolves, but little monsters called box trolls. These are the monsters under the bed every kid encounters growing up. The difference here is box troll boy gets caught by a little girl, and he has to make a go of it in the world of humans. The little kids will love it.
Pleasure to meet you. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Never seen one do that before.
The Box Trolls.
Off with Box.
A little bit of everything. Yeah. I like the comedies. I like, you know, a good movie book adaptation, so.
Movies with Denzel, John Travolta, action movies.
Any. Chick flicks, rom-coms, action movies, anything really.
I like movies. I like movies. I really do. And I like action films, too. Wow. I mean, I like, yeah.
And how often do you see movies?
At least once a week, sometimes twice.
Wow.
Yeah.
Bang Bang?
How was it?
It was great.
Now, here's a family comedy. Well, a comedy about a family, anyway. About a man whose wife leaves him for his boss. And as if that weren't enough, he loses his dad. His dad has one final wish. His wish is for his dysfunctional family to spend the entire week together without leaving the house. When you put Tina Fey, Jason Bateman, and this all-star cast together, comedy is guaranteed, and this is where I leave you.
Starting over is complicated, and you don't do complicated, Judd. You never have. Anything can happen. Anything happens all the time.
Yeah! I've been chasing this idea about a perfect life. Yeah. And irrational and complicated. And I want a complicated life.
It seems everyone is looking forward to going to the movies, having some popcorn, having some slush with sugar on top. And if moviegoers have teeth next week, we look forward to seeing them again. From New York, the city that never sleeps, for Saudi 2's Cinema Weekly, this is John Wallace. Back to you, Nihad.